In Atlanta, some teachers are going to jail. I'll tell you why. Plus, there are a lot of questions about the 73-year-old officer who shot the unarmed black man Eric Harris in Oklahoma, pants on the ground while committing a crime. I'll tell you the interesting story next. It's time for your Dash Cam D. 11 educators in Atlanta, Georgia are being sentenced for committing what some are calling the biggest cheating scandal in the history of the U.S. These educators, they work at the Atlanta Public School. On their state standardized test, they were either giving students the answers or just simply erasing the wrong answers that the students marked in their test. And they were doing this so that they could meet target standards. It's also possible that they were doing it for the incentives that happen when they meet those standards. So three of those educators of the 11, they're going to be sentenced to serve 7 years in jail. The others, some have 2-year sentences, some are on house arrest. So you all heard about the Tulsa, Oklahoma officer, 73-year-old Robert Bates, who shot and killed an unarmed black man, Eric Harris. He was involved in this sting operation where Eric Harris was under investigation for selling guns. And when he found out that he was being set up, he ran. And that led to him being tackled and ultimately shot by Deputy Bates, because Bates thought he pulled out a taser and it turns out he had pulled out his gun and shot him. Well, now Bates has turned himself in and he's being charged with second-degree manslaughter. His lawyers say he shouldn't be charged with it at all because it was simply an accident and it was not meant for him to shoot Eric Harris. But some questions have come up. Because he is 73 years old, people are wondering, well, what was he even doing on a case like this, that he's never been involved in a case like this before? How many hours of training did he have? And he had 300 or so hours of training. Also questions of his reasons for being a reserve officer. So apparently he has donated a lot of equipment to the police force and also money to different people's campaigns. So people are now alleging that his contributions is what is allowing him to be a police officer, and his lawyers say that's just disrespectful to even say that. So a lot should be coming out soon. Should a 73-year-old officer be involved in such a high stress situation? Should he be on the streets trying to clean up gun crime? Let me know below in the comments. Also, America's dumbest criminals. Police in Los Angeles have released this surveillance footage of a guy who is committing a robbery at a gas station. Well, the funny thing is his pants are on the ground. He's climbing up a building into where the clerk is, and he puts a whole bunch of cigarette cartons in a trash bag. But the whole time his pants are falling down. He just forgot his belt, apparently. I don't know how you expect to commit a crime with your pants around your ankles. And the whole time that his pants are falling down, and not once did he stop to try and pull them up. But I guess when you're in the heat of stealing, you gotta hurry up and get in and get out. Well, that's all the news I have for you today. Tell me what you think about the stories in the comments below. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube at WLB Miller TV, at Dash Cam Beats, and of course, as always, hashtag Fox 26 for Life. Peace!